Greetings everyone. Welcome to Inspired Conversations, the show where we leave the legacy with the legend. Now today I am joined by another legend, an author, a speaker and entrepreneur. His name is Mr. Siyabonga Ndlozi. Mr. Siyabonga Ndlozi, welcome to the show, sir, and thank you for coming.
Thank you for the invite, sir.
Now, someone, when he hears the name Ndlozi, he's thinking of EFF. can you please just clarify to the viewers, who is Mr. Siyabonga Ndlozi?
Oh, Siyabonga Ndlozi is an author, a speaker, and an entrepreneur. I'm an author of 3 books. The first book, it was The Infinite Treasure, where I was helping people to understand that they have infinite treasure within them, that even if you make a mistake, even if you do something worse, but there is a treasure within you. And then the second one, of which it is this book, it says, build your own ark. After you have understand that you have treasure within you, you need to build an ark, because if you remember the children of Israel, wherever they go with the ark, of which it was protecting the treasure of God. So that's why I'm telling my readers to say, build your own ark. And then after the third book that I've written, it is the Flow. It is my third book, The Flow Changing Lives. The Flow Changing Life, it's a mindset that you understand that you have a treasure within you. You have built the ark to protect that treasure. But the treasure will not work for you if you are not moving. So the flow, it's a mindset of winners. It's a mindset of game changers. So I'm inspiring people in this book to tell them that you need to work for what you want. So basically that's what I'm doing. I write books, I speak, and I help people to publish books. Yeah, that's what
okay.
I'm doing.
So as I hear you, your books actually go in order.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, from this one, your message is actually flowing.
Yes, sir.
And the book, The Flow, I understand that you actually named your business The Flow.
Yes, sir.
After your book. Can you tell us about The Flow?
You know, after reading all the books, you know, every time I write a book before I title the book. That's my style of writing.
Okay.
So I write with the inspiration. Like most of the time when I write books, I pray to God, direct me what is it that I have to write. And when I was writing the book, and when I finished writing the book, I thought I would call it the lacking key, or the keeping power. Because the idea of this book was, when we're looking at other people, like they start projects and they don't finish them.
Yeah.
So for me, and I was suffering from the same thing, because I dropped out 3 times in 3 different universities, because I started this project, I started studying engineering, and then I said, this thing is not for me, and then I left it. And then I went again to study something else, and then I dropped out. And then it came to myself, say, what is it that is keeping, that keeps me wanting to quit, not wanting to finish? Because if you keep on quitting, you never achieve.
Exactly.
So when I was writing this book, I remember when I finished writing, I sent to my publisher that the title of my book is The Keeping Power. And I was praying around 3 a.m. in the morning. And then the word flow just came into my mind. And then I just opened my laptop and sent an email at the same time to my publisher. I please change the name of my book to The Flow. And I did that before understanding. I didn't understand the word of the flow, because I thought the flow, it means about when there's a flow like water,
yes,
and stuff.
Yes, yeah.
But when I did a research about the word flow, it's about the mindset. Like when the keeping power is the same thing. When they say people, when you tap into your flow, you're unstoppable. And for me, it was just a revelation. But wow, there's something that called the flow. And then from there, the book, it is The Flow Changing Lives. I have a company called The Flow Franchise, and I have a publishing house, The Flow Publishing House, and I have The Flow Music, The Flow Films, and everything, because it came to me as a revelation.
Okay, so everything is about the flow.
For me, it's even when I speak, I want people to tap into their flow, because you can do something, but until you tap into your flow, you will never achieve the highest potential.
Hmm. Oh, that's powerful. Now, after you struggled as an author,
yes, sir,
you have mentioned that you decided to help other authors not to struggle anymore. he wanted them to be the best authors as much as possible.
Yes, sir.
That's why you started Buhlali Literature, an initiative where you help authors. Can you please tell more? Can you tell us more about Buhlali Literature?
Okay. Buhlali Literature Academy, it's an academy for writers. Because I wanted to, at first it came as an initiative for authors. But when I sit around and look around, but you know, the challenge is not for authors, but the challenge is for writers. People who write music, people who write movies, people who write books, they have a challenge because in South Africa, the current economy is not conducive for those kind of art. It's even better for musicians because they were able to break even. But when it comes to us, especially authors, you find many of us are struggling. So we sat together with the other directors of which it is Ubabu Uzoyisile Nomenbafo and Uki Obaka Owaheng and myself. So we sat around and then we said, what is it that we can do so that we can assist people? Because you're an author, you understand the challenge that you write your book with a mindset that my book will change my life. But after publishing your book, you see that actually I've lost money instead of making money. So we said, let's come with an initiative because the challenge is, it's not that we are not good writers. But the challenge is we write books, but there's no market. There's no one. Like, we cannot put our books in shops. We cannot, like, even we don't even have exposure to programs like yours where we come and speak about our book. Then we said, let's bring together sort of a society of writers where we come together and discuss what is it that we can do to give each other an exposure. So we started an award ceremony of which this is the award that we're going to give on the 2nd of November to those guys who entered the awards. But the main thing for this is to expose each other, because like there are many awards for different genres like music, and it might not be seen, but those awards, they do a lot to musicians, because if you receive an award, it's a sort of a recognition to say there's something that you are doing to the art. So that's what we are doing in Buhlali Literature Academy. There are three things that we do. We first inspire writers, and we empower writers, and we expose them, because I think it is important, because as a writer, it's most of the time it becomes a lonely world, because it's something in you nobody else know. You have to write and share with the world. So we inspire them to say, work on your craft, develop your craft, because there are so many things. There are many products that can come out of the book, but many people are not aware of that.
Yeah, I also wanted to ask you that question. You had mentioned that you made example about a tree, you know,
yes, sir,
that many authors are actually limiting themselves. For example, out of a tree, you can find a wood, you can find a furniture,
yes,
you can find a paper, you
yes,
understand?
Sir.
So how? What are other products that can come out of a book or out of an author?
You see, this book, okay, let's be practical, because I think it would make sense if we are practical.
Yes.
This is the book, The Flow Changing Lives. Out of The Flow Changing Lives, there is a city that came out of this.
Wow.
Where I write poetry about motivation.
Okay.
And there's a movie that will come out of this thing.
Okay.
Where there are songs that will come out of this thing. There are programs like my company, The Flow Publishing House, come out of this book. Because after writing the book and reading the book, you know, it's so amazing when you write, you don't understand what you're doing. You write, you pour yourself into the project. But when you come back and read your book, it is something like, for me, this book changed my life. Because after reading it, I saw the franchise. I saw the publishing house. I saw the music that can come out of this way, The Flow Records. I saw The Flow Films. So that's what can come out of books, because people, they think books is all about this, because there's so much. Companies come out of books. And you know, like I was doing a research, and I was amazed of the power of books, because there's nothing that can be done in this world without a written contract. If we have to do something, so someone must write.
Yeah.
So a writing career, it's a career that will last forever. But it's just that people, they don't maximize. Do you know that writers, like the guy who did A Black Panther, one movie, it makes $1.5 billion US dollars. Wow. That's the power of that is vested in writing. Yeah. And people, they don't understand, because out of this, we can develop a script, because the question is the flow changing lives. How does it change? And this is a story, in this one, it's a story about a young man who received wisdom from an older man. And we can develop a script out of that. And if we are creative enough, we can do magic. Hmm. So the Bulhlan Literature Academy, it's about that. It's to inspire, it's to make, so that we can get the cream out of the writers, so that we can inspire them to become the best.
No, that's a good initiative indeed. Now, as you speak about books, how are you encouraging the public about reading? Because obviously when you write a book, someone must read your book.
Must read your book, yeah.
And we have a challenge, you know, in our country where we have only limited people who actually like reading. So how are you encouraging, you know, the readers to read your books?
You know the challenge that we have, we don't have enough material to read. It's not that people, they don't want to read.
Okay.
Because like, if you look at the countries like that, they have a high level of literacy, like America, mm-hmm. there are many writers in America. You go to Thailand, there are many writers. You go to, like, many countries like that have a high level of literacy, it's because they have many writers. Because As a young person, if I'm inspired by you, like I need people around me who will inspire me. But if people around me are not writing books, if I'm reading a book written by a guy from America, I will not understand, because the struggle in America is different. But if you write a book and someone in your community, they will read the book, not because they will read the book just as, I know the author of this book. So my contribution in that, I make sure that I help people to publish books. You see, for me, that's what I do every day. Like, I'm working on books every day. I make sure that we have many authors as possible. Because if we write our own stories, like if you're looking at today in South Africa, we have a challenge of unemployment, we have a challenge of crime, we have a challenge of so many things, teenage pregnancy and all of those things. But if we as writers, we don't write about those things, not in a sense of talking about those things, but in a sense of coming with a remedy on this thing. So my contribution is helping people to write books and helping people to publish books and bringing resources, because for me, it costed me like 40,000 to publish my first book. Hmm. And I was able to do that because I was working. And for me, I ask myself, what about a guy or say so, a guy or say Deben who doesn't have that amount of money? So I started the Flow Publishing House so that I will help those guys who doesn't have money, because we break the project into pieces. Like, this is what you can do, this is what you can do, this is what you can do. You'll be amazed. I started my company last year, but we have published more than 15 titles now.
Oh,
because we the goal is to help people to publish. I'm telling you, if we can write books, children will read our books. And we need to write books that make sense to them. Because like the way that we write about success, people, they don't understand how so-and-so from abroad became successful. But if I am looking at what you are doing, it's a story of success. If we document that, it will inspire a kid from a next door to say, if Mr. Okarapide was able to do that, why not?
No, that is true indeed. So what are you guys doing to encourage authors to write in their own language? Because that one is it's a challenge.
you know, like, it's a challenge, because there is this stigma that someone who speaks English is wiser than someone who speaks, yes, like our native language.
Yes.
But to tell the truth, most of the guys that I'm working with, I encourage them to write in their languages. Like, we have published a book in Sesotho, Setswana, and there's a book that I'm working on isiZulu. And we still want people to write in Tshivenda, in all of those languages. Because, you know, many black people, they have a problem with maths. You know why? Mm-hmm. Because maths is written in a language that they don't understand. But like, if maths, it can be written in our own languages, in isiZulu, if you speak Zulu, you have a maths in isiZulu, you have an accounting in isiZulu, you have a law in isiZulu, we'll become smart, because it's our mother tongue. So that's what we're encouraging, especially in Bulhlan Literature Academy, because we are looking at like African. We want to promote Africanism, mm-hmm. because if we don't encourage people to be proud of being African, it's a challenge, because we'll have a society without identity. So in my company, I encourage that. And we're producing a lot of both. Like, if you can give us some time, you'll see. There are many products that will be produced in our own languages, and it's possible.
Mr. Ndlozi, if people want to know more about this initiative, Bohlale Literature Academy, if they want to know more about what you do, where can they find you?
The best way, because we are on social media now, so they can search Bohlale Literature Academy. They can go even to our website, www.bohlaleacademy.co.za, and they can find me on social media, Siyabonga Ndlozi. And even for those who want to publish, they can find my company, www.theflowpublishinghouse.co.za. So we are everywhere, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Ndlozi, for your inspirational conversation, sir. And I'm looking forward to have you again in our show.
I thank you, sir.
You are watching Inspired Conversations, the show where we leave the legacy with the legend. I believe you have been inspired, encouraged, and motivated. Keep tuning, and we'll meet again next time on Global Conference TV.